Hey, this is Seth from No Code MBA, and in this video, I'm going to talk about the differences and similarities between Bubble and Webflow. Bubble and Webflow are two of the most popular no-code app and website builders out there today. I use them for the websites and apps that I build, and I want to talk a little bit about why I would choose Bubble over Webflow or Webflow over Bubble, depending on what I'm building. And hopefully by the end of this video, you're going to know which no-code tool is best for the project idea that you have. If you want to learn more about building apps and websites with no-code, get step-by-step tutorials on how to build real projects like a Reddit clone or an Airbnb clone, or building an AI text and image generator using Bubble and OpenAI, check the link in our description to go to nocode.mba to check out our full in-depth tutorials. Okay, let's go ahead and get into the video. So here we are on Bubble's website. What Bubble is best at is building interactive, dynamic web apps. So what that means is an app that has a database that is going to dynamically show that data on the web page, and it's also going to have logic. So an example of that are apps that users are going to log into. They're going to have accounts. They're going to be able to take actions inside of the app, and you're going to be able to build all of that logic inside of the app. So the main benefits of Bubble are that the database, the workflows, which is the logic, and the design is all integrated into one platform. With other no-code app builders, sometimes you have to have an external database and connect that to the no-code tool, which makes it a little bit more complicated to use. There are pros and cons of that approach as well. But something that I really like about Bubble is how easy it is to get started with because everything is integrated into one app. It also scales really well. So as you have more users onto your app, it'll scale kind of like any web app that's connected to servers like Amazon Web Servers is going to scale up as you get more users. So that's something that's really great about Bubble as well. Webflow, on the other hand, is meant for building websites. They also have functionality in terms of e-commerce, so you can build an online store. They have some functionality around memberships or allowing people to kind of access content behind a paywall, and those are really helpful features as well. But the main reason that I would recommend using Webflow is to build really beautiful websites. So a website being something that someone would just go to, kind of like this, we're on a website here, but there's no ability for people to log in and actually take actions and have an account on a website. So it's more of a marketing site. It's really good for marketers to build out websites and have it designed really nicely. You can also do have a CMS, which is a content management system, which allows you to store information and dynamically show it on your website as well. But it's not something that users are going to interact with and change the data in your database. That's something that you would change. So let me give you an example of this. So if we go to nocode.mba, this is a website that's built on Webflow. So everything you see here is built on Webflow. We have different pages here. And just as an example, in this tools directory, each of these is being dynamically shown on our site because we're storing it in our Webflow CMS. On the other hand, this is what No-Code MBA looks like after you sign up and log in. So this is built with Bubble. And the difference here is in Bubble, users are actually able to track their progress as they take courses, track how many lessons they've created. There's community posts, so users can kind of interact with the app itself. They have an account, and you can build much more custom user experiences using Bubble. So that's the difference between Bubble and Webflow. On Bubble, you can build full app experiences, while on Webflow, you're building websites that are really good for marketers to use, for companies to use as their marketing sites. hopefully that helps to explain the differences about Webflow and Bubble and kind of tell you a little bit more about, you know, what projects are going to be good for Webflow, what are going to be good for Bubble. And also you can see how, you know, some projects are you're going to want to use both tools because you're going to need a marketing site using Webflow, and then you're going to want to build your app using Bubble. That's something that I've done multiple times myself. If you have any questions at all about this topic, please just leave a comment below. I'd be happy to answer any questions that you have. If you want to learn more about building with Bubble and Webflow and other no-code tools as well, check out the link in our description or go to nocode.mba. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more no-code content in the future, and I'll see you in the next video.